billion shillings to upgrade the Mandela National Stadium to international standards. Sports officials say it will save Uganda embarrassment as it will be hosting the upcoming FIFA World Cup qualifiers in neighboring countries. The National Stadium in Nambole was declared substandard by FIFA in 2019, but nothing has been done yet to renovate it.
We have also a letter dated 21st May 2020, signed by Keith Mwakanizi, Permanent Secretary, Secretary to the Treasury. When you read in item F, in their own report on the systems, processes and structures of Mandela National Stadium, they highlight the poor physical state of Mandela National Stadium, among others.
Currently, Uganda has no stadium that meets international standards to host international football games, which is causing panic amongst sports ministry officials. The 42,000-seater stadium was closed in October 2019 for upgrade, but to date, no renovations have taken place. Today, the State Minister for Sports, Dennis Hanson Oboa, together with the stadium's executive director, Jamil Sewanyana, appeared before the Budget Committee of Parliament to ask for 97.2 billion Uganda shillings to renovate and upgrade the stadium.
The Ministry of Education and Sports, through the minister, wrote to the ministry to constitute a technical team. The technical team did due diligence. This is what we were calling needs assessment. And they came out with the BOQ to a tune of 97 billion shillings that we feel will be done in a phased manner for us to renovate and upgrade Mandela Stadium to internationally accepted standards as per FIFA and CAF regulations.
19 billion Uganda shillings is needed for installation of VIP and ordinary seats, 6 billion shillings for CCTV and PA systems, 9 billion shillings for electrical installations, and 8 billion for the main arena running track, among others. The sports ministry wants to renovate the stadium in two phases.
We believe that this particular budget, if we can't find it all, the reason why in our presentation we are requesting we can phase it out in two. Because apart from the areas I've stated, there are also additional areas, but that falls within that budget. So we are requesting that if it cannot come at one go, we can phase it in two phases, such that the first phase, we will be able to handle the most critical areas that can allow us play. Then the second phase will now come to finalize the planned upgrade and renovation.
Oboa told the committee that without a stadium to host the upcoming World Cup qualifier matches, the country is in a terrible crisis.
Mandela National Stadium, or our motherland, Uganda, does not have an approved public stadium to host international games. Our first international game is scheduled for June this year, and in that same group we have Kenya and Rwanda. We have even been told in black and white by CAF and FIFA that if we do not renovate Mandela National Stadium and upgrade it to an international accepted standard, our country Uganda will have no option but to choose one of the countries within the region where we shall be playing all our home games.
But committee members tasked the minister to account for Nachivubo Stadium, whose status is a myth since it was given to a private developer.
When we were discussing this issue, a member raised the issue of Nachivubo Stadium. What is the status of Nachivubo Stadium? Can we consider it at all?
As we look at it in terms of just physical exercise, but sports like that national team provides access to tourism. It's a marketing tool. Having a team play and recorded and televised worldwide is a big marketing tool for tourism. And the earlier we restructured our sports with the Ministry of Tourism together, the better.
I personally visited Nachivubo Memorial Stadium after going through the documents. The record available is that the redevelopment of Nachivubo War Memorial Stadium is under the public-private partnership arrangement. We entered as government through the board. The issue of developing the pitch, a 30,000-seater stadium, was an addendum to the first one. And this was signed in 2017, and according to the record available, it is supposed to run for 5 years up to 2022.
West Budama North MP Okoth Othieno, however, asked Obua to fire the current management of the stadium, whom he accuses of mismanaging it.
The minister should tell us, what is he going to do with the management of this stadium? Are we still going to leave this stadium? We inject 76 billion and leave the stadium in the same management team with this AD here, who now thinks about, isn't you? Who thinks about using the facility as a sport, as a dancing facility? And so I think you need to assure us. We look for what's the contingency plan you have because this is coming. But what are you going to do with the management team, which has misused?
An issue was raised on management. Before COVID, Nambole was employing 38 Ugandans. What we have done is to start the process of downsizing. And this process of downsizing is with the ultimate goal of having in future a perfect management team.
During the climax of the COVID-19 surge last year, Nambole Stadium was turned into an isolation facility for COVID-19 patients. This story was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news in Parliament.
Well, away from that,